Hello, it's Keith here, and this is lesson 53 of the platform-specific series of my Z80 programming tutorials. Today we're going to be looking at flipping sprites on the Amstrad CPC, but the concepts we're looking at today would actually work on a lot of other systems as well. Yeah, systems like the ZX Spectrum also have the same kind of screen and would it just work just well as well with these flipping routines. In fact, the Mode 2 one will work pretty much as is on the Spectrum. Now, a system like the MSX2, this wouldn't work on, but some of the systems are definitely going to be able to benefit from the concepts that we're looking at today. Now, what's the problem with the screen modes and the flipping of sprites on the Amstrad CPC? Well, the problem is basically that because there are multiple pixels stored in a single byte and the combination of those pixels isn't particularly convenient for flipping things around, we're going to have a bit of trouble when it comes to flipping sprites. And we're going to need to flip sprites because we don't have enough spare memory to store two copies of each sprite with the character facing both directions. So that's going to be our problem. And the solution is we're going to have to come up with some calculations that we can perform to convert the sprites. And the way we're going to flip those sprites is going to differ depending on the screen mode that we're using. So basically, depending on the screen mode, the number of pixels and the bits per pixel is going to be different. In mode 2, it's just one bit per pixel, and the bits are in a very even organization. If you look at this image here, each color represents a different pixel, and the letters are different bits within the pixel. So this pixel here, moved to this pixel here, is just going to be a shift, and we would actually rotate it to the left, pushing it to this side here. This one here would need to move to this one here, so we could move it to the left a few times, wrapping it round to here. But this one would need to move to the right to here, and this one would need to move to the left here. That's in mode 2. That's pretty straightforward. But in mode 1, we've got a bit more tricky things going on. Now, in this mode, of course, there's two bits per pixel, and the bits that make up the leftmost pixel are this one here and this one here. Now, they're going to need to shift to the right to here and to here. Now, the next pixel along uses this bit here and this bit here, and so on and so forth. So we're going to need to do various bit shifts and masks to move these around into the correct positions. Mode 0, different again. It uses 4 bits per pixel, but the bits are all scattered around like this. So again, a bit strange, but that's what we're going to have to work with. So let's go over to our code and let's see what we're going to use today to actually flip the images around. Now, before we run any of today's examples, let's run our classic example and see what the standard bitmap looks like. So here's our classic Tubico bitmap that we used in the simple series, and you can see it's facing to the left. Now, if we go to our flipping routine here, and we compile this one, and we run again, we just need to make sure our screen mode's set correctly here. Just set this to mode 1 here, and run again. And if I do call and 1200 here, you can see we've now flipped the Tubico character facing the other direction. So how have we done this? We've defined a series of macros to do the conversion required. Of course, depending on the screen, we're going to need a different set of shifts. And for convenience, we'll define some macros because then we can use them in different places in our code. So here's the one for screen mode 1. Here's the 2 bits needed for the leftmost pixel. And we're doing 3 rotations to the right here to get them into the correct positions. Whereas this one here, we just need to do 1 shift to the right. This one, we just need to do 1 shift to the left. And each stage, we are saving the result in C and ORing it in for the next stage because we're having to mask out each of these pixel bits accordingly and shift them around, and the end up result will be in the accumulator here. Now that's mode 1. Mode 2, we're having to do this many more times because we've got many more pixels to shift around. You can see they're just all shifting around there. And mode 0 is actually the easiest because there's just 2 pixels, and the weird checkerboard pattern of the bits actually makes it quite convenient for bit shifting around. So the mode 0 version is quite straightforward there. The easiest way to use these is simply in our drawing routine here, which is basically the same as it was before. All we do is we read in the pixel that we want to draw to the screen in the accumulator from the sprite data. We then run one of the macros, and then we write it back to the screen here. And that's all we did when you saw this example here. And that will flip around. Now, the disadvantage, of course, is I'm sure you know that macros, while this is just one line of code here, the assembler is actually converting it to all of this code here. Now, if you've only got one sprite routine, that might not be too bad. It'll be a bit slow, but it might not be too bad. But if you've got dozens of different sprite routines for different purposes, the amount of code is going to start getting quite big, and the speed is going to be a problem if your sprites are quite big. There is, however, another alternative. What we can do is we can define a bank of memory, 256 bytes, and we can pre-calculate every possible input byte and the equivalent flipped output byte, and then just read in from that lookup table the conversion and then just draw that straight to the screen. And that's what we're going to do here. What we've done is we've defined 256 bytes and we've aligned on a 256 byte origin. And what this means is that the bottom byte will be zero. It'll start at zero and it will go up. And so what we can do is we can just add the byte we want to convert to our starting address of this lookup table, read in, and then that is just the equivalent flip byte. All we need to do is at the start of our program is fill this table. And of course, it's pretty straightforward to do that. Where is it? Here it is. So all we're doing is we're starting our lookup table. Now, because the bottom byte starts at zero, and that is the color we want to convert, we're just loading in the accumulator from the L part of that pair. We're then running the correct conversion depending on our screen mode, and we're just storing the result back into the lookup table, and we're just repeating accordingly. And that will fill our lookup table. When we want to use it, all we need to do is we're loading in BC with the address of the lookup table. You can see that just here. And then when we want to convert a byte, we read in the byte, we want to convert it. So we load C with the byte we want to convert. And because that table is byte aligned, the result we read back will be the flip sprite. And then we can just show that to the screen. So for 256 bytes, we've gained the ability to quickly flip as many sprites as we want in the future. And I think this is probably going to be the best way for you to do flipping of sprites if your game needs it. And if your game's relatively large, especially on those 64K systems, it's not quite as fast as if we didn't need to flip sprites, but it's going to be pretty close because there's not many commands here. So as I say, I think this is going to be the best way of flipping sprites for the CPC. So let's just run this, and actually let's just change it and let's do a mode zero example this time. And if we just run again, you can see we've now got the flipped mode zero sprite. And I mean, it was so fast you probably can't tell, but we were using the lookup table that time. And of course we can do a mode zero example as well. And there it is. You can see that all of these are now facing right. The sprites that we are in memory, of course, are all facing left. So there we go. And that's really all there is to it. I mean, it's a bit tricky working out how to convert the pixels for the screens, but once you've got it done and you've got those macros in place, you can use them wherever you want. So say either in real-time conversion or using a lookup table, which is going to be the better way of doing things. Well, I hope you found that interesting. Please go to my website. You can download all of the source code for today's examples and, of course, the sprites. The sprites were all made with Akka Sprite Editor, my free open source sprite editor. So go ahead and grab that as well if you want. Anyway, if you enjoyed this, please like and subscribe. Take a look around my YouTube channel. I've got loads of the systems I cover, both for Z80 and other CPUs. But whatever you do, I hope you enjoy programming the Amstrad CPC, and I hope you enjoy programming in general. Thanks for watching today, and goodbye.